My wife's situation is a little different, you know, how we met, you know, through mutual friends and everything like that. You know, when I met my wife, she was 17. So, you know, we had no really conversation and no really connection until, you know, she was of age. And, you know, it's, people don't understand it. And I got a lot of course, I got a lot of backlash for marrying someone that was 19. And, you know, when we did finally start to talk, I was like, this woman is like me. And she was just like, when I would talk to her, she just, for one, we had a spiritual connection. And I feel like that's the most important thing. We both love God. We both love Jehovah. And that was key. And being able to start being around her and talking to her and talking to, like, we got it. We connected through music. And, you know, her spirit, her kindness, her heart reminds me a lot of my mom. And just, you know, we connected on so many different.
Man, something not adding up, man. Look, Marques Houston, something's not at. Let me sip my Starbucks. This man said he met her when she was 17. That means he was 39, because when they got married, she was 19, and now he's 41. That means he was 19 when she was born. Yo, you can't make this up, bro. Like, come on. And honestly, we know about the history of, you know, that whole camp with Marques Houston. What their name was? IMX. Who else was in that? B2K, Chris Stokes, all of that. Razz B already exposed that, being touched by some of them guys. I don't trust it, man. Like, you really, you know, happiness happens every day. I'm not saying a man don't find love within 2 years or his wife, but a 19-year-old, bro, yo, something just not right, bro. Like, y'all don't see something that right with that? That's crazy, bro. That is crazy, man. Look, that mean they've been together for 3 years if he married her at 19. I don't see nothing wrong with love, you know, and she is of age technically, but it's just a little off to me. You know, shout outs to all the married couples, though.
Hey, little girl, come on and dance with me. Are you about the cutest thing I ever did see? Hey, little girl, I'd like to take you home. Come on, come on, come on, I want you for my very own. All right, now. Better hang on tight. I want you to swing it to the left and shake it to the right. Hey, little girl, you know you're looking fine. Getting ready, honey, let's go just one more time. All right, huh?
All right, here we go. We got another suspect video. Y'all ain't gonna cancel your boy Elvis. Well, I mean, he's long and gone. Like, he probably been canceled. But he said a lot of things that was just kind of sus in that video. He said, come on, baby, I want to take you home. I want you for my very, very own. And they got like 5 years old. I work with kids, man. So I know how it is. You know, we have cases where there are grown men, you know, trying to touch on little girls, pedophiles, right? That's what we call them. I don't think that, like, this should have been respected. First of all, when this first came out, this should have been questioned. But, you know, times back then was way different from how it is now. And to be honest, I don't think that, you know, people would have really said much, because he is Elvis, and he ain't black, he white. So clearly you got people like R. Kelly, Michael Jackson, all these people who had allegations or did things. I still don't think Michael did anything, but what, R. Kelly roped up right now. He ain't doing nothing, and he can't do nothing, okay? So Tell me what y'all think about this, man. We gotta protect the kids. Love y'all families. Love y'all self, man. One love.